Hello and welcome to a new Plugin Guru video. My name is John Skippy Limcool. Welcome to all of you. This is a video covering the synthesizer Alchemy. And this is a synthesizer that was first available by a company called Camel Audio for the PC and the Mac. And then Apple purchased that company and it now lives in an updated version inside of Logic Pro X. A lot of the tips, probably most of the tips that I'm going to share will apply to the older versions as well as the new version. There's some things like the convolution reverb that are different. The layout of the oscillator itself is a little bit different, but the way it works and the way that modulation assigning works and the way the live performance area works, that's all the same. So you'll be able to learn from this all sorts of cool things, I'm hoping. with the PC and the Mac version of Camel Audio's Alchemy, as well as with the Logic Pro X version of Alchemy. So now, this first 10 minutes of this video will be available for free to watch at YouTube. And after that, if you want it, you need to come to my website and buy it. Continue learning more from the video. So pluginguru.com, there will be a video for just the video by itself if you want it, or it's available in a power pack, which also includes ESX24 version of Mega Magic Dreams, as well as the Alchemy version of Mega Magic Dreams, which is even more fleshed out. There's more things you can do, of course, inside of Alchemy than you can in ESX24. So the performance is all set up to do cool things to the sounds. We'll do a patch walkthrough in a separate video. There's also patches for the source, patches for the effect presets. All of the patches that I made for the original version of Alchemy are included in this power pack. They are not inside of Alchemy when you get it from Apple. They offered to buy them from me, but I said no thanks. I wanted to put them into my own library. So here they are for the first time. So let's get into Alchemy and learn lots. Here we go. So this is the fun of Alchemy here. Just so much fun changing just two samples. One going through an arp and one just as a pad. So much fun. So let's talk about the interface real quick. Let's get this interface, how it works to start with. There's three buttons in the top left that let you see between the browser with the performance controls, just the performance controls, and then the synthesizer, the advanced, shows you all the synthesizer parameters as well as the performance controls. So you can choose which one you need. If you click here, you can choose and go down the browser this way and just see everything. If you're over here on browse, you can actually choose a category or and then break it down even farther, even which sound library you want, or there's articulations and all sorts of different parameters you could use for searching the library of patches to go through. You can even just do Sound Designer, but unfortunately, everybody that made patches for Camel Audio got turned into just Apple, which is too bad. But Sound Library is very useful because there's some really nice libraries. Visions is one that gets into some kind of more out there experimental types of patches that are a lot going on. And if you go to the Advanced page, you can see this is only two oscillators because only two of the four little areas, quadrants, have a blue light on their A, B, C, or D, so that means there's two. If you hold down Option, you can click and just solo. And hold down Option and click B, and now you're hearing B. Right? Option click again, and now you have both. Now, over here, this is your kind of your master changing of what you're going to see up here. Global lets you see the four oscillators and some basic parameters, plus the filter, plus your master section. The voices is where you have your voices of polyphony, up to 32 voices is the max. Polyphony, glide, if you want to have glide on a patch, here's that parameter. When you go to A, B, C, or D, all of this changes, and it's now showing you specific things to that oscillator. Because the oscillators are so freaking powerful, they can do all of these different forms of synthesis per oscillator. And some of them, if you have this, even, I think even here, if you're using granular, I think you can also turn on additive synthesizer and the virtual analog synthesizer, which is waveforms and unison and all that stuff, while it's playing a sample at the same time for one of the four oscillators. So it's extremely powerful what you can do right here in synthesis. We'll get into the details in a bit. This is more just an overview. So you can change between the four oscillators here. There's morph. If you want to morph like a XY pad and volumes between them, you can do that. As you get over here, you get to the modulation area. Let's say initialize. So we have an initialize preset. If you want to have an additional envelope, one thing that's interesting. So you have LFOs, and as you can see, there's only one. And envelopes, there's only one. And multi-segment, there's only one. Envelope follower, we're probably not going to play with it too much. That's kind of an abstract. It's like a lag processor, can speed up and slow down. It's cool for like changing shapes to be not perfectly what they are. Mod map lets you like key track or stuff like that, or do velocity curves, and you can change how you want that to work. I'll show you that and when we get to programming a patch. But these are your parameters. And if you want, all you have to do is right click and say add modulation. And go to the amp envelope. It's considered an AHDSR because there's a hold segment. So we'll say add. And by just doing that, this number for envelopes just changed to 2. And at this point, it's assigned it to the filter cutoff, you can see, but the intensity is at 0. So if I want to hear this, I have to turn this down. Then I have to turn this up. And then bring down the sustain. One thing I love is that it's real time. So as I play a note, if I bring this down, I hear the results. A lot of synthesizers don't do that. You have to re-trigger a note to hear any changes to the synth engine. It's so nice to work with the synth where I want to rest right there. I want to add some drive, some resonance. If you go between even these 12 dB, there's quite a few different ones, but listen carefully. There's different personalities in them. Especially as you bring up. The envelopes can get super snappy. One thing to be aware of is that when you assign a parameter, if I want this to be controlled by velocity, then you can right click on this and say add modulation and add note property of velocity. And it's an add, which means you can have this filter cutoff intensity even at 0. And then see this, that's the range that velocity is adding. And you can right click on this and say edit modulation to see. And you can right click on pretty much anything. You can right click on the decay and say velocity and negative. So it can start really long. So it's very easy to program with these modulation sources the way they are set up. Multi-segment, multi-sequence envelopes lets you double click in here on the line. If you, I think, right click anywhere, you can add as many segments as you want. If you hit sync, it's now following tempo, and these now will be moving to the defined timing points. There's a looping ability. If you click right here, you can turn on a loop, so it can loop the entire thing or just a part of it. So it's really cool for Let's say we go to this guy, and instead of it being the AD, all you have to do is click on the knob, and it will show you what this yellow part is, which is the modulated. That's some modulation source is changing it. If it's blue, that's where it's at. And if it's yellow, gold, that means that the modulation is being done by something. Let's click here. And instead of it being that envelope, let's just change it to be here. Now it's looping. I could have it set to sync. I can make it shorter. And there's some cool things down here for editing, for short, for changing it. Slide will allow you to slide everything after the point. And this stretch is really cool because it can stretch the whole thing. So it will do like, then have this repeat right here. You can do crazy stuff like that very easily. Sequencer is just that. It's a step sequencer of values. So you can have a sequence that's changing volumes like a modular synth, changing the filter values with moving things like this, while it's also doing pitch. It's very easy to set up. We'll play with that when we're making patches in a bit. And as I said, mod map is for key scaling. Let's do this. Let's initialize and say, if you were to do typically with a filter, as you go up the keyboard, it disappears, right? So that's why they have a key track parameter. For example, there is no key tracking on the filter. So one thing you'd want to do typically as you go up the keyboard range, the filter goes away. And I want this to be nice and bright. So what you can do is you can find a middle range, right click on this and say modulate this under note property. These are things that happen to do when you play a note, whether it can be random, flip-flop, there's all sorts of fun things, a max value. The number of notes of polyphony can actually be changing as a modulation source. Really cool stuff. Let's just say key follow. And as I go up the keyboard now, as you can see, as I go down and up and up the keyboard, now it's balanced, right? So there's also, and this list, if I was to go over here and then say add an LFO and add a new envelope and add, let's say I wanted to have velocity. As you can see, this keeps growing and it'll just grow as long as it needs to be. When you get to the more complex patches, you can actually read and see what's going on with the patch by just clicking here, and it will show you what's been assigned in the synth to the different parameters. The performance, sometimes this list will get quite massive. It's very impressive. Yeah. All of these parameters are assigned over here to these 8 knobs, to the XYs, to the envelopes. Very cool. So it's very cool how this synthesizer is laid out. There's a lot of power. The effects are found right here. There's main effects, which, and you also have effects over here per oscillator. So each of the 4 oscillators can have effects while the main has its own effects. Parameters here can equally be assigned to these knobs, as you can see, so that as you're changing this, you're changing effects. Parameters inside of the effects can be changed by LFOs, by other envelopes and other performance modulation sources. Very, very powerful. And then on top of this, there's an arpeggiator and there's an all arpeggiator, but there's also A, B, C, and D. So like at the very beginning when I was playing, if you have your browser set to a certain category, then when you're clicking here to go through it, you're going to only see that category. So let's go back to all. All on the top says all, right? So now we can see, get to the M's. If you get to the end of this list after synths, you'll see that there shows up a Z. This is how I signify patches that are bonus. Right here in the BPM, right here, Arp and Pad Partners. Using Mega Magic Dream samples, but it's a pad. It's got the really cool arp on the other side. We'll make a patch like this so I can show you how to do these. Okay? that's the layout. It's wonderful. It's a wonderful synth. It's amazing it's included inside of a sequencer that you buy. I'm going to take a break. We'll come back and look at the oscillators in detail. That's next, because there's a lot to know about those oscillators all by themselves before you get to everything else. Okay, so see you in a minute.